Dulcinea is one of the oldest Spanish restaurants in Manila, started in 1963. The founder, Señor Santos Ruano, left his grandparents' pasteleria in Spain in 1961 and traveled to the Philippines. Bringing his grandparents' recipes, Señor Ruano opened up the Dulcinea Pasteleria y Salon de Té on Mabini Street in Ermita Malate, which has now grown to 15 full-service restaurants nationwide, having been sold to a Filipino Chinese owner who has expanded the business. Today, we visit their Greenbelt Makati branch, and while the Spanish dishes may now have a Filipino touch, there are still many items on the menu to rave about. We would highly recommend the Gambas, Coctel de Camaron, Sopa de Mariscos, Salpicao, Lengua Estofado, Salpicao con Gambas, Pollo Alla King, and for dessert, Negrito, Borracho, Eclair, Ube and Malunggay Ice Cream, and of course, one of the best Churros con Chocolate in town.
Hi everybody, we just arrived at Dulcinea in Greenbelt 5. This is actually one of my favorite Spanish restaurants in Manila. It's one of the oldest and it's really a taste of my childhood. So one of my favorite appetizers here to start is always the gambas, which is sauteed shrimps in olive oil and garlic. And they have a really decent gambas here because it's very garlicky, very decent sized serving, 10 shrimps. And the shrimps always have a good bite to them here. Wow. Wow, these deep-fried shrimp look good. It's a warm marinara sauce.
It tastes even better. Well, that's a good appetizer.
Crispy and yummy.
Yummy, right?
I like their Sopa de Mariscos, which is a classic seafood soup. This is served with mussels, shrimps, squid. It's in a very light tomato-based soup. Mm.
heartwarming.
Now I'm having the soup of the day, asparagus soup. I asked them, is it canned? They said no. They said it's fresh, but it kind of looks powdered to me. Tastes a little bit powdered. So the best soup is their sopa de mariscos. Tried the paella. It's tasty, but I wish they used a little bit more squid ink. It seems a little bit pale when it should be very dark black. It's still tasty, but it could be better with more squid ink. But I like that it's served hot and there's a lot of squid inside.
Alexandra.
It is so bad.
I want bread. One of my all-time favorites is salpicao. Now this is tenderloin cubes sauteed in garlic and olive oil and usually served with garlic rice. But the version here at Dulcinea is just fabulous. Ultra tender tenderloin. Very garlicky. And very flavorful garlic rice as well. That just goes down the hatch so easily. Up next, I'm having a classic, Lengua Estofado. So this is ox tongue, simmered for a long time in spices and topped off with gravy and mushrooms. So let's see how tender this, oh wow, that's super tender. It must have been fresher cooked. Ox tongue doesn't get any better than this. Just fabulous. It's like ultra tender. This is highly addictive. I call this dish the best of both worlds, as it has two of their best dishes all in one. It's the gambas and salpicao.
Papada is okay, but a little bit dry. I've tried it in another Spanish restaurant and it was really like the stew, more liquidy and more ingredients. I like martilla and I was expecting it to be more, but I had only one piece.
And it looked like there was only one piece of mortilla in the whole fabada.
Yeah, I guess so, which I always do. beans, and they like beans. Okay.
So one of my favorite comfort foods here is Pollo Alla King. This is chicken cooked in a creamy mushroom sauce served over filo pastry. This is very enticing and it just really hits the spot. Serve with french fries and assorted veggies. It's just perfect with the french fries. It's a very flaky filo pastry. How is that pollo in almond sauce?
It's okay. With the breast, a little bit matting gas. And the flavor is not so powerful. Which is okay for me.
But looks like they got some real almonds there, right?
Yes.
Real almonds.
Shaved almonds.
Asparagus. It's a healthy meal. Wow, that blue marlin steak looks fantastic.
Yeah, most important is fully cooked. But I think maybe it was poached
first. Poached first and then pan seared. The edge looks even crispy.
Yeah, try.
How's the lemon butter? Is it real butter?
Most of it
margarine. Oh, that margarine action going on. Sayang. But I think the fish itself looks pretty awesome.
Name of three meal out.
Alejandro. That sounds good for you.
Which one do you want?
This one. Like a poop. That one like a poop.
Like a poop?
Yeah. I don't know.
Okay, try that negrito.
I can't slice it.
Here, use that also. Just bite it.
It's super yummy and chocolate. And sweet. It's like an Oreo. That's all. But I can say. It's yummy.
Just bite it from the outside. Ha ha ha!
yummy.
Borracho, which means drunk, it's actually one of my favorite pastries here. And there's rum inside. It's so moist and soaked with that rum, but it's not so overpowering. And it just melts in your mouth. This is a must try at Dulcinea. Wow, that is the most powerful homemade ube ice cream I've ever eaten. The flavors of that taro root crop, they just really pop out. It's just unbelievable. It's very rich and tasty. Malunggay is actually known as moringa in English, and it's loaded with a lot of vitamins and minerals. Very healthy for you.
Thank you.
So, wow, that is packed with flavor. I can't say that actually tastes like the actual leaf, but it's not so sweet. Seems to be also quite grainy, the ice cream. I like it, and especially with all those health benefits.
Thank you.